Green light to go. Great launch there from Tristan Avedon as Vittles again fails to get away from the line. This is exactly what he did yesterday, and that is from bad to worse for the Latvian driver. Failing to finish in Q1, now failing to get away from the lights in Q2, or at least very quickly. He does eventually manage to get away, but he's quite a way down the rest of the order. So it is then Avedon who leads the way from Mike Seller as they come through on the gravel for the first time, flicking it into the right-hander, climbing up the hill. Then they're going to emerge onto the tarmac once more. And this is where the Joker lap, of course, begins for these drivers. Unlike Lyddon Hill and unlike Pembrey a couple of weeks ago, the Joker at this circuit is towards the end of the lap. As you can see, you go to the left of those cones, through the hairpin, through a chicane, and then back on to this start-finish straight. But it's advantage Tristan Avedon then in Q2 race two here so far. Down the bottom of Duffer's Dip he goes, on the brakes, get the car rotated into the dirt section, through the concrete on the first part of the dirt, then on to the gravel. And then you can see he's going to thread the eye of a needle through this very tight and twisty section of the lap. I think Robert Vittles failed to make the end of that first lap, so whatever technical problems he had in Q1, maybe they have come to rear their head here in Q2. And as such, the Latvian driver will go no further. So that's two races, two non-scores for yesterday's winner of round four of the Five Nations British Rallycross Championship. And that is a big, big disappointment there for the 18-year-old Latvian, because he will just be, I imagine, pretty inconsolable after this, having had such bad luck after such supreme fortunes yesterday. If you remember, in the final, he managed to pull away quite commandingly at the end of the race. Just completely caught me by surprise. He didn't manage to get away from the lights at all in that race either, but managed to just keep his nose clean, as it were, whilst everybody else around him was faltering in the tricky weather conditions that the track was based with at the time. And as such, he just crept up onto the back of the rest of the field and slowly got himself further up the order as everybody else made their jokers and made a few mistakes. And as such, he took the win in round four here yesterday and managed to become the first driver to win two rounds of the Five Nations British Rallycross Championship in 2021. So Tristan Avedon leads the way down towards the first corner then. This is the final lap of the race. Mike Seller's gone joker out of the two remaining drivers that are competing here so far. So down in towards the first turn will Mike Seller go, and he sits in second position, and he is not going to be anywhere near Tristan Avedon once the 72 has made his joker at the end of this lap, because Seller was quite a way off and seems to be struggling somewhat here at the Knockhill circuit. So the bonnet flapping away on Avedon's car as he goes into the joker, gets the car rotated, taking a nice tight line there and sliding that Citroen DS3 through into the chicane, on the brakes, flick it left, flick it right, start finish race awaits, and it's Avedon who takes the win in Q2 race two here at Knockhill. Mike Seller will come home quite a distant second position, and out of the three runners, only two sadly will make the checkered flag after the early exit from Robert Vittles. Over the line then comes Seller to complete the order here for Q2 race two. But it's Tristan Avedon then, the driver who finishes on top at the end of Q2 race two here at Knockhill for round five.